to returning jihadists. Jihadists who have raped girls, women, men, and probably animals. Jihadists who have watched or taken part in beheadings, floggings, stonings, and amputations. Sadiq Khan's London is open to Pakistani hate preachers. Hate preachers who are banned from addressing large crowds in their homeland are welcome in London and allowed to tour mosques, poisoning minds and encouraging a hatred for all things Western. Sadiq Khan's London is open to unmonitored mosques. Mosques where children are beaten, sexually abused and raped. Mosques where children are raised to hate Jews, Christians and infidels. Where children are taught that gays and apostates deserve to be killed. Sadiq Khan's London is open to those who wish to practice FGM. Mutilate your daughter's vagina and the full force of the law will look the other way. Instead of punishing those guilty of this barbaric crime, the police will organise conferences, campaigns, hashtags, and initiate a zero tolerance day that will mean nothing and result in no arrests. The message to those who force FGM onto their daughters is clear. Carry on cutting in Sadiq Khan's London. Sadiq Khan's London is open to rape gangs. Gangs whose preference it is to rape young underage children, mainly white working class girls, with no fear of intervention from the law. Sadiq Khan's London is open to grown men who pose as child refugees and who thereby deny a real child a chance at a new life. Sadiq Khan's London is not open to any female who wears a dress size smaller than a 12, thanks to the removal of body positive adverts on the underground. Heaven forbid we shame anyone by looking good ourselves and taking care of our bodies. Sadiq Khan's London is not open to anyone who will help post-Brexit Britain like Trump. Our greatest friend and ally. Khan's personal feelings are placed above the interests of the nation and his words are spoken outside the role of his office. It is not Khan's place to determine who does and does not enter the UK, and he does not speak for the entire population of London. Today, Khan's London is not open to anyone who wishes to tell the truth about Islam. People like Brittany Pettibone, Martin Selner and Lauren Southern are all banned from entering the UK. Sadiq Khan's London is closing to people who identify as white British. White flight is a real thing. And many people have left or are in the process of moving out of London. Have a look over the 2011 consensuses from every London council and borough. The facts speak for themselves. Imagine how bad the number will be when the next figures get released in 2021. Sadiq Khan accused me of being a mean tweeter and hurting his delicate feels. Yet Khan and his office can't even source the author of a tweet because they are so incompetent, in spite of the fact that they have set up a hate crime hub that is costing the public millions of pounds to go after all of us free speakers. Mean tweets matter more than knife crime, drug gangs and acid attacks in Sadiq Khan's London. My freedom of speech to respond to Sadiq Khan. You can't take care of business. Stand down. You're not fit for office.